What's up, YouTube? Angry Jackalope Rob Ricks. I am live, unfiltered, coming at you, motherfuckers. So, here we go. Let's get this shit started. I'm going to try to have some kind of organization here. I normally just kind of fly off the fucking handle, just do whatever. So, I'm going to try to get a little bit organized here. So, this is episode one of the live show. So, I'm hoping you guys are going to dig this shit. Yesterday, we did a little bit on the alcohol. Today, I've got a few more bottles of different things, and I think that's what we're going to go ahead and get started with. I'm going to start off with this bad boy right here. Mm-hmm. This one. Get it up here so you can see what it is. Arctic Mint. So this shit, this blue ice, is going to be crazy. Why, thank you. I'm glad you like my hat. I'm glad you like it. What's up, Jeremiah, my brother? All right, so I have to make a decision. You know, normally I try to, you know, drink in moderation. And so, you know, this is the traditional shot glass, right? You know, this is traditional. It's you know, no big deal. It's just a kind of your standard shot glass, right? Not bad, not bad. I can't do you guys like that. I can't just do the regular shit. You know what I mean? I gotta come a little bit more angry jackalope. You know what I mean? So we're gonna pass on that one. Here's another one I have, right? But this is a little bit more on the edgy side, a little more cool, you know what I'm saying. This one right here is it's also about the same size, but it's a little heavier, a little more, you know, ready to rock and roll-ish, I guess. But this one, nah, this ain't gonna work either. This ain't gonna work either. You know what I'm realizing is my chat box is getting obstructed by that fucking arrow. Let me go ahead and I don't want people to not be able to see. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scoot this guy up a little bit higher like that. Ready to gear. Two in a row, nice. Yes, indeed. Suppers. Now, I realize this is a little on the fucking ridiculous side, but this is substantially bigger, and it says, "America, fuck yeah, y'all." Now, if I did shots out of this all fucking night, I'd probably be fucking dead. So, we're not going to do that. We're not going to do that, but I am going to use this when we get to the Jameson portion of the tasting. So I'm going to go ahead and use my I Love Beaver because I think, you know, that's an aptly named shot glass because I do indeed love a beaver. Yes. I prefer bald beavers as opposed to hairy beavers, but that's neither here nor there. So let's go ahead and let's try this Blue Ice 101. Now this Blue Ice 101, this is 55% alcohol. It's 101 proof. So this is a little bit on the heavier duty side. You know what I mean? So right off the bat, I took the top off here and I could smell it. Woo! I could, there's some mintiness. Minty, minty, minty. I could smell it already. All right. So we're going to pour it in. And whoa. Okay. This is coming out like cough syrup. Wow. Okay. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see that. Here, let me see if I can get it up towards the camera here so you can see the viscousiness of it. It's like kind of like syrup. Syrup. Oh, it smells really good. Smells like mouthwash. So, I mean, you know. All right. Okay. All right. Here you go. I'm going to turn it so you guys can see the I Love Beaver. And I'm going to say, I love my viewers. Okay, let's go ahead and try this. Oh, that's delicious. Oh, that's dangerous. Whew. We're being 101. 101 proof. That is incredibly smooth. Wow. Wow. That's good. I like that. Yeah. Okay, So right out the gate, Blue Eyes 101 is definitely Angry Jackalope approved. Holy shit, that's good. God damn, for 55%. That's some dangerous shit right there. I think that's more dangerous than Fireball, personally. Indeed, I think that's more dangerous than Fireball. All right. I'm going to put that glass over there because I don't want to mix my other shit in there. Now, I don't know if you guys are familiar with a brand called Jeremiah Weed. Yes, Jeremiah Weed. You heard me correctly. It is by far one of my favorite whiskeys because it's kind of a sarsaparilla mix. And it's really fucking good. Like, it's one of my all-time favorite whiskeys by far. Well, I was down in Vegas, and I came across a variant from Jeremiah Weed that is cinnamon-based. What the fuck? Cinnamon whiskey. Okay, now, I enjoy myself the motherfucking Fireball, you know, Irish Zombie Nation in the fucking house. What's up, my brother? I'm getting fucking drunk before I get to the news and all the other shit that I'm going to tackle on this fucking show. But just to catch you up, I just tried this, and I really enjoyed this quite a bit. This is called Blue Ice 101, and I like it a lot. I like it. I likes it. It's fucking smooth and delicious. Okay, now this Jeremiah Weed Cinnamon Edition. So my mouth is all wintery, you know, wintry, tingly, tingly. So I'm going to go fire and ice on this bitch. Okay, I just went with the ice. I'm going to bring the fucking fire. Okay, I'm going to bring the fire. Let's do this shit. Now this one, I'm going to put it in my Punisher. I'm going to put it in my Punisher one. Okay, Punisher bitches. Put it in here. Blup, 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 blup. I did about half. I went about right about there. I got to go moderation. I did a little too gonzo yesterday, and I think it impacted me, my cognitive abilities, slightly, just a little bit. All right, motherfucker, so here we go. Cheers to your fucking health. Oh, my God, that smells fucking great. It smells like a fucking, little cinnamon red hots. You know what I'm talking about? But I think all of them kind of do. Like, I know Fireball definitely does. Sinfire does. And this one now, Jeremiah Weed. Let's see. Let's see what the fuck happens here. I'm out in the woods drinking right now. Jameson. Hey. I'll be right there with you in a minute, brother. I'm doing a comparison between standard Jameson and this one. So, yeah, we'll be able to toast and shit virtually. Just hang tight for a second. All right, here we go. I got to try this one out. Because, yeah, I got to start the episode off getting a little bit lubed up, you know, mentally lubed up so that the filthiness can freely flow from within my fucking mind. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, enough bullshitting. Here you go. Cheers, motherfuckers. God damn. Woo, that's good. All right. Second approval. I think this is just going to be a fucking approval night. I think the motherfuckers are going to get mad. Angry Jackalope approvals for this evening. So, yes, Jeremiah Weed. Cinnamon whiskey is by far Angry Jackalope approved. Yes, we're going through this shit in a rapid succession. We are rocking and rolling. We are getting it going. All right. Now, since we're rocking a Jameson, I have two glasses here, okay? I've got my America, fuck yeah, giant shot glass, and I got my traditional drinky glass that I use just to fucking drink with, okay? So what I'm going to do is, since this guy is, you know, is used to just the regular Jameson, I'm going to go ahead and pour myself a little bit of my standard Jameson. Oh, yes. Boom. Just like that. Okay? Pour a little bit of this. Out that back. So that's the one I always drink. That's the one I always drink, right? All right. Let's get the cask mates now. Cask mates. Now I'm a little sad But the Castmates just has a twist top. Doesn't have the, you know, the regular get down. But that's all right. I don't give a fuck. Because I'm not drinking a shit because of the presentation. I'm drinking a shit because I fucking like it. Okay. Okay. There we go. Let me get the top back on this motherfucker. All right. Let's do a side-by-side comparison, shall we? Okay. Let's go ahead and do a little sniff on the original. Oh, yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Well, yes, baby. And then the new one. Oh, wait a minute. There's, you know what? There's not a real pronounced smell coming off of the new one. Fuck it. All right. You know what? Cheers, motherfuckers. Yeah. Let me some fucking Jameson. All right, Irish. Leo, my brother. Okay, let's try to cask. Try to castmates out. Right? Oh, wait, what's it called? Castmate, right? Caskmates. Okay. Once again, motherfuckers. Cheers. That one has kind of a more smoky, richer flavor to it. Yeah. I like it. I likes it a lot, motherfuckers. All right. So both of the Jamesons. Come on. Did we have any fucking doubts? Angry Jackal approved. Boom! Angry Jackal, motherfucker. All right. That being said, fucking. That was delicious. That was Tom. You let's see. Let's see. What did you miss, Tom? You only missed 1, 2, 3, 4 shots. You didn't miss anything. We got the 101 proof, blue ice, definitely delicious. We had the Jeremiah Weed. Cinnamon whiskey, delicious. We had just standard Jameson. Delicious. What's up, Matt, my brother? We had the Jameson Castmates. Very delicious. All four of those are by far Angry Jackalope approved. I am happy to say that this episode did not have any losers, did not have any nasty shit. But yeah. As far as Jeremy, yeah, more cinnamon. You know, I do have Sinfire. I haven't had Fireball in the house since the great Halloween debacle where there's footage floating around of me screaming Bon Jovi's Dead or Alive. Yeah, I was karaokeing like a motherfucker. Oh, my Lord. I was holding the wall up. I was gone. But that's what happens when you drink one of them giant fucking fireballs. Okay. So I'm just saying that's the shit that happens. All right. So moving right along, there was a couple of things I wanted to talk about. I saw the new trailer for Star Wars. And if you are one of those Star Wars fanatics that watched it and was like, oh my fucking God, it is great. I'm disappointed. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm motherfucking disappointed. I was looking at that shit. I was like, I was disappointed. I really wasn't all that impressed by it. I was like, all right, whatever. I'm sure as it gets closer to Christmas, they're going to start bombing us with the fucking whole storyline. But I was still kind of like, whatever. Now, was that ready to gear? What watch you wearing? This one? This guy right here? This is my cheap Chinese Surefire knockoff. This is the one. You just go. I couldn't spend $600 on the real deal, so I spent $20 on it. I'm sorry. Sorry, Surefire, if you're watching this shit and you're like, that motherfucker is supporting fucking cheap Chinese knockoffs. Look, man, it shouldn't cost no $600 for a fucking wrist light watch. You really should. That's kind of fucking ridiculous. It's redonkulous. It's fucking criminal. And I'm addressing that. I have some Indian developers helping with some 3D models and some other stuff. I will have an Angry Jackalope wrist light, which will be coming very soon. And I think when you guys see it, you'll be like, yes, it's very low profile. It's very ingenious. It's very nice. And the best part, it's not going to be fucking expensive. Because I hate that shit. I really do. I really can't stand when there's kit and gear I want, but I cannot fucking afford it. It just drives me fucking bananas. I can't fucking handle. I just can't do it. I can't do it. Anyway, there were some movies that popped off that I wanted to talk about real quick. Logan. I'm pretty much sure we've all watched Logan. I'm not going to do any spoilers or anything like that, but it was really good, and it made me cry. It made me cry like a fucking baby. Really fucking, I boobed. I fucking cried. Only a father, I think, would get hit like, I mean, it felt like somebody just punched me in the heart. And my son's being a little asshole. He watched and he looked at me. I'm all having a moment. And he looked at me like this. Are you crying? I'm like, shut the fuck up. What's up, Tim? I was like, yeah, I'm crying. Shit's fucking emotional, man. Damn. What the fuck, man? Why aren't you fucking crying? He's all, I don't know. And I realized he didn't get it. You know, there's a part at the end there where there is something that's put down on the ground, and that just broke me. It was a great movie. It was a great fucking movie. I loved it. Logan, Angry Jackalope approved. By far, if you have not watched that shit, and you are a Wolverine fan, whatever, it was good. It was really, really fucking good. And it moved me. It moved me like no comic book movie has ever moved me before. I felt touched in the feels, and I'm not ashamed to admit it. Speaking of other things that made me fucking cry, just to get everybody in the same page that may not have been around when all the shit was going down last year, I did I found out a good friend of mine, a girl named Natasha Yama, a girl I went to school with, she had developed breast cancer as well as cancer in some other parts of her body. And I did a fundraising thing to try to help her out. She died. She passed. And that was the other thing that really affected me and, made me fucking cry like a little bitch. So there was a Facebook post that I did when I was trying to tell some of my peers that our mutual friend had died, where I just broke down. And so for the last few months, I've been dealing with a whole lot of grief. I've been dealing with the loss of somebody that I cared for pretty deeply, and that was pretty insane. It was a crazy ride. Anybody who's lost somebody will understand exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. What's up, Angel? What's up, brother? So that was another moment that was a pretty pivotal for me. Now, getting back into the entertainment stuff, a lot of people were talking, some smack, this, that, and everything else about Iron Fist. I actually enjoyed it quite a bit, and I'm going to summarize where I think a lot of people missed out, because I just touched on grief. I also want to point out that grief is one of those fucking things that kind of really takes you for a fucking loopy ride. So when you watch Iron Fist, understand two things. One, the martial arts in there is lackluster at best. It's not the best martial arts you've ever seen, and anybody who's done any kind of training in martial arts is going to be a little bit offended by watching this, because when you have shows like The Badlands that are out, that is just fucking awesome. I mean, ridiculously awesome with the shit that they got going on a regular TV. Netflix should have spent a little bit more money, a little bit more time training, et cetera, to get the martial arts up to where it should have been for basically a martial arts show. But that being said, I actually really enjoyed Iron Fist. I'm looking forward to seeing Iron Fist join up with Luke Cage and the rest of the crew for Defenders. So, that'll be good. We'll see what happens with that, right? All right, so now, moving on, continue with the fun shit that I've got planned here. Watch this. With the twinkle twinkle of my fucking magical fingers, let's get into the news, shall we? All right, so there's a couple things I wanted to talk about in the news. What's up, Brian? There's a couple things I want to talk about in the fucking news. And first and foremost, let's go ahead and talk about some of the decisions that the Dawn has made recently. So the Dawn has been really ballsy, been doing a bunch of stuff. Like them, hate them, whatever. I'm pretty fucking indifferent. I really don't like him, and you know, I accept he's my fucking president. That's it. You know, I just wait and watch and see what the fuck's going on. But he dropped the biggest bomb short of a fucking nuke. And we know we're talking the Moab here. Dropped the Moab on some motherfuckers. Now, here's the problem I have with dropping the Moab. So stats have come out. Roughly 90 plus people have fucking died. And I'm like, that's it? That's a big fucking bomb. I mean, you got a mile blast radius and you only killed 90 motherfuckers. So that tells me somebody in the intelligence industry is fucking up, because shit, I can go with my eyeballs and find a fucking spot and kill more than 90 motherfucking people with a mile radius fucking bomb. Now, one thing I also wanted to point out is the cost of the Moab. There's a lot of shit floating around there saying it's fucking, you know, hundreds of millions, 13 million, et cetera, blah, blah, blah. But a final report came out. It's like $170,000. So basically, it's $1,700 per kill, which is not too bad if those are targets of interest. Now, if you look over in Syria, Sonny asked if I've ever watched Breaking Bad. I saw some of Breaking Bad. I watched like the first four or five episodes. I know I'm fucking shitty. I should have watched the whole fucking thing. I just have not had a chance to binge watch that bitch yet. But getting back to Syria just had a car bomb where they killed over 100 people. So we're fucking up pretty bad. That's huge. We got to fucking fix that. We got a fucking problem. Somebody needs to get fired, because we dropped something that cost $170,000. We killed less than 100 fucking people. Somebody rigs up a fucking car bomb, and dude, what is up with the Trump pick? That was a ping that I found that was kind of funny, and I thought it was really crazy. Yeah, waste of firepower to kill only 90. Yeah, Hellfire would have been just as effective. But, you know, they said they were down in tunnels and shit like that. I'm like, you know what? If these are targets of interest, send in two good fucking guys, they'd fucking kill a lot more than that fucking 90. Anyway, a little disappointed about that. Now, talking about other disappointments, Kim Jong-un must be really fucking disappointed, because a lot of crazy shit was going on. There was some talk of, you know, North Korea going to unleash some really crazy stuff, and people were really afraid, oh no, they're going to have some nuke stuff. And we brought some fucking shit out there, and, you know, the Moab was basically dropped, not really to kill those 90 motherfuckers, but more as kind of to say, hey, look what we got, motherfucker. We still got 19 more of these. You want us to drop some of this shit on your little ass? You know, your little pudgy ass? And speaking of pudgy, it's funny how the media always refers to Kim Jong-un as the pudgy little dictator, or the little rotund little dictator. Like, they always point out he's fucking fat. And I'm kind of like, yeah, I get it. That's funny. Ha, ha, ha. You're making fun of him. But the whole reason everybody's kind of worried is the fact that this motherfucker might be dumb enough and crazy enough to actually fucking cause problems. Magic says, if they blew up all the tunnels too, though, that was main part of the target. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Infrastructure is a big deal. Yeah, fuck the world, man. It's all fucked up place we live in. People need to open up their eyes about stuff. Yeah, no doubt. So it's crazy because I guess apparently today he tried to set off some rockets and they blew up. Okay, that sucks. But I think that's pretty telling in regards to their technology. I don't really think Korea is that big of a deal. So when I look at what's going on in Syria, I look at the Afghanistan stuff that was dropped, and I look at some of these other things that are going on, I can't help but think some of this shit is just a little bit distracting, especially how quick the news is all covering and everything else. So, you know, we'll have to wait and see. Now, continuing with the news, there is a penis, not just a penis, but there is a penis injection that cures impotency. So if you can't get your dick hard, there's a fucking shot, which seems crazy to me, because if you stick a fucking needle in my dick, I'm pretty sure my dick's not going to get hard. But the only reason I cover this story is not only does it cure impotence, but it makes your dick bigger. It makes your dick bigger. And it's a thin needle. So what they do is they take some of your blood. So they take blood out of you. They spin it around and they get stuff to a certain point, and then they put it back in your junk. Okay. But they numb you up. So I assume, like, in my mind, I'm picturing they got like some hot Swedish chick there. She's like, you know, stroking your shit, stretching it out with some numbing agents and shit to get your stuff numb. Right. And then they withdraw some blood from you, and she's constantly just stretching it like some fucking taffy or something, you know, and then they inject it back in. You don't feel anything, and suddenly your dick is bigger. I don't know. I think I might try it. I think, you know, that might be something interesting to try. I might take one for the team. I don't have any impotence problems. I can get hard, strong like bull, but I ain't gonna lie. I'd be happy to get a little bit more. You know what I'm saying? Not have to rely on the old cock ring to add a little extra girth to the shit. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, let's see. Let me continue on the news here real quick. That's the death toll. We already talked about that. Kim Jong-un showed off his shit where they goose-stepped and everything. I do like the quotes coming out of North Korea about how they would basically fight back against us. We will pulverize the headquarters of evil and ruthlessly ravage U.S. troops. So they're already talking about fucking the U.S. troops, because you usually hear ravage. It's like, ravage me, ravage. I know you could also use ravage to fuck something up, but, you know, commonly you say, oh, ravage me, you know? So it's like, okay, are they like fucking gay soldiers that just want to fucking fuck our troops and shit? Then they say they will do merciless strikes on South Korea and U.S. bases as China wars of war at any moment. So you see a lot of saber rattling, a lot of bullshit going on. I'm thinking like Public Enemy right now. Don't believe the hype. Don't believe the hype. Anyway, moving on here. So now a lot of the tools that the CIA lost control of and the NSA is starting to surface up in the world. So if you've got any Windows computers that are facing the internet, what I mean by that is if you have a home server that's on your home network and it's hosting out and the world can hit it, you might want to lock that bitch down, because there's a lot of shit floating around that will fuck your Windows machines. And my Microsoft's not going to update and address that shit probably for like 2 or 3 fucking months. So if you've got one, it's in your best interest to fucking pull that bitch off and not have it sitting out there. So if you've got some porn and some other shit that you're sharing with friends and stuff like that, and it's outward facing, you might want to tell them, you know what, I can't get it to you. I'll put it up FTP somewhere. You can grab it somewhere else. And I think that is basically going to be the news that I have for right fucking now. Yeah, that's it. So cover the news. Boom. Go back here. Here we go. All right. So alcohol is still pretty good. I want some more of the frosty shit. The frosty shit is the higher alcohol content, but it's also the most smooth out of everything here. I think it's the most evilly aligned of the glasses. So I'm gonna grab my I Love Beaver shot glass. Gonna pour some more in this bitch. Bloop, 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 bloop. Oh damn, I think I poured too much. This shit comes out like a motherfucking, excuse me, this shit comes out like fucking cough syrup. It's so viscous. It's so thick. That's what she said. Nah, nah, nah. Ooh, this coats. Woo. This comes out like fucking fresh bubble gum. You know what I mean? Like some Winston's. Oh, you know what it reminds me of? When you bite into a fucking York peppermint patty, right? Like when you bite into a York peppermint patty and you get blasted by fucking Arctic winds, right? That's the shit. That's what bloom just blowing around in my motherfucking mouth. It's like Frosty the Snowman. Never mind. So anyway, that was delicious. I fucking enjoyed the shit out of that. That was fucking yummy. Let me check the time here. Let me see what I'm doing, because I'm trying to pace myself. So everything that I fucking basically had, I was able to rock in 30 fucking minutes. I'm fucking happy with that. I am very happy with that, because now I could just fucking wing it, fuck off, and have a good fucking time for the next 30 fucking minutes. But yeah, that was basically what I had planned in a nutshell. Now, I really shouldn't do this after I'm drinking all this, but I'm going to start grabbing some fucking knives. Let's grab some fucking knives. Let's look at some fucking knives, shall we? Yes. First on deck, let us grab the Topps Crazy Blade. Crazy, crazy, crazy blade. The one, the only. Oh, got another strap here. I had to pull the strap off. That sounded wrong. Ignore what I just said. We have us here, the Topps Tracker Digger. Tracker Digger, Tracker Digger, Tracker Digger. Now, this blade really, really, really caught me by surprise when I first saw it last year, I think. I think last year I saw this design. I think it was last year. And when I saw it, I thought it reminded me of like a Hawaiian war club. Okay, so if you're not familiar with the Hawaiian war clubs, they're basically wooden clubs with like shark teeth in them, but they have a very similar shape. Okay, now, let's see, hey, Rob, do you smoke type pipe tobacco? I'm just getting into the hobby. Actually, Tom, no, I don't. I don't smoke any tobacco. I don't smoke weed. I don't smoke pretty much anything. It's just, I don't know. I just never. I thought about a cigar. I gave cigar a real solid thinking at one point because I kind of wanted to have that Scarface feel a little bit. You know, it was like, my name is Tony Montoya. You know, I want to have a fucking cigar, you know, but I didn't do it. And so, no. Yeah, I've never tried it. I do know quite a few folks that do go with a pipe, but I have not. I have not. So, can't really comment on that. Black to this bitch right here. So, when I first saw it, I thought it was going to be a lot bigger. A lot bigger. But I got it, and I've had it for about a week now. And I was a little disappointed because they sent me 186. And it would have been nice if they would have sent me number 187. 187 on a motherfucking cop. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about. It's all about the 187, right?
Yes, all about the 187 indeed. We like it when it's violent. We love the darkness. We love the destruction and death.
You know, Damien, you're always so dark. Just go back in the corner. Go in the corner there. So, yeah, you guys go ahead and work that out on blends. I don't know. I'm useless in that regard. So, you know, I asked Craig. I said, Craig, what the fuck is the purpose of this bitch? Because for me, this looks like a fucking combat blade. It looks like something just to fucking Hassan chop the shit out of motherfuckers in their head and, you know, gut check and just pull out large chunks of stomach and stick it inside of a spine and pull out a vertebrae or something like that. You know, that's what I was thinking. And he was like, well, you know, it's for digging. And I'm like, digging? Really? Okay. I'll roll with that if that's the PR point of view. But me personally, I'm going to say this motherfucker is designed for combat. You know, as far as bushcraft or something else, I mean, yeah, you could probably dig for some fucking truffles or something like that. But for the most part, I'm very interested to see if the tip is going to be able to handle the impact in the dirt and shit like that. Because, you know, here in Utah, our dirt is just filled with fucking boulders and shit. You know what I mean? Yeah, Matt, I was thinking the same thing, but I take monster shit. So I'd have to dig a big fucking hole for my fucking poop. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, this might work. So I'm going to be testing this out. I'll be taking this through its, paces and everything else, but I did want to share it with you guys and let you take a look. And I will let the guys come in and chime in on it. Let's ask Steve. Steve, come here, motherfucker. Get over here. Why don't you come over here? Yep. Get over here. That's right. Don't be shy, motherfucker. Fuck you, Rob. Damn, alcohol done burned my throat. Steve's the hardest voice, by the way, to do, if anyone ever wondered which of the voices were fucking hardest to do. But, you know, I have to get mentally prepped with Steve. Sup, bitches? There we go. I got it now. Okay. So, Steve, what do you think about the Tracker Digger?
Well, I think it's small enough for me to rock and roll. And I want to ride on it like a surfboard.
All right, you're fucking useless. Get out of here. You're dumbass. Go. Go away. All right, Randy, motherfucker. Where are you at? Come here. Get down here. Get bigger. You're too small. There you go. Nice and big. Randy, what do you think about it?
Yeah, I like it a lot. I think it's pretty fucking cool. I think, you know, you could take that shit,
You could like pop somebody in the back of the head with it. You might cut half the head off. You know what I'm saying?
Jesus Christ, Randy. That shit's usually reserved for fucking Damien to say, you sick fuck. What the hell, dude? When did you get so dark? Anyway, get back over there. Get over there. There you go. They're all nice and sized now. So if I have to pull on them again, you know, I could grab them and talk to them again. All right, let's move on. I got another fucking blade for you guys to check out. I really am excited about this motherfucking blade. I definitely think from a gut point of view, black. I mean, this, rack. I definitely think this is combat. That's just me. I mean, look at the ass end. That's not meant for digging. That's meant for fucking up somebody's day. Bink. So anyway, I wonder if this bitch can be thrown. I'm going to find out. All right. So I had a fucking tree that fell. A big bunch of branches. So I got a chainsaw out there. I'm working a chainsaw. I'm doing this, that, and everything else. And my kids go, can we grab a couple knives to go out and fucking chop some of these branches with to make them smaller so that we could carry them in the backyard? To which I said, go ahead, right? I'm up in a fucking tree. I'm up fucking 20 feet in the air, cutting limbs off, trying not to fucking die. And what blade do they decide to come and try to chop fucking branches with? They grabbed my fucking shred fucking elven sword, okay? They grabbed the elven sword. I'm like, by the time I hear him, pling, 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 whack, 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 pling, whack, whack, and that bling, bling, by the way, that's them chopping on the ground and hitting fucking rocks, okay? I'm just like, I look down and I see it, and I'm like, are you fucking serious? Yeah. Yep. They chopped the shit out of all kinds of shit with it. And I'm like, wow. Okay. So I don't know if you can even see it because this webcam is so fucking low quality, but there's chinks. There's chinks all along this fucking blade. Now, they were out there chopping like fucking Hassan choppy motherfuckers for a good 40 minutes before I noticed it. And then by that time, it was too late. And I said, fuck. And they were all dripping sweat because they're trying to chop a fucking a limb the size of my thigh with this shit. And I'm like, oh, no. I have failed as a father to explain the correct types of blades for the correct types of usage. So this Schrade SCHMBS is not designed for wooden fucking limbs. So if you're wondering, it'll survive because you can see the tip. They were stabbing it and bending it. Oh my Lord. And of course I didn't catch any of that shit on film because like I said, I was up in a fucking tree dealing with some other shit. So I was like, seriously guys, what the fuck? All right. Well, you know, what's funny, Mr. Nomadic Hunter. You want to talk about some zombie tools? Well, that's funny because that's the next fucking blade I was going to grab. I think you're fucking psychic. All right. So we've got. Shing! We've got the fucking felon motherfuckers. You know, this is good for, you know, shaving. I'd be careful because I am a little bit inebriate. Not a lot. I got a little good blood buzz going on, but I get to see, try to look at the camera and do this, and then go click. Oh fuck! I stabbed my eyes. That'd be some YouTube gold, wouldn't it, motherfucker? Oh my God! I lost my fucking eye. I lost my fucking eye. Right? I wasn't going to actually brutalize the felon, but I have made a decision recently that I am going to hard use test this because I realize not a lot of people have done really hard use testing with a felon. So there will be a hard use test on that. Okay. Soon. The next one I want to show you guys is the motherfucking Bacra. Ooh, bitch. Ooh, bitchy. Back it up. Shunk. Oh, what if Damien's ear just came right off there? Shunk. That would be like fucking cool CG right there. Anyway, this is the Vakra. This is Zombie Tool's answer to a Kukri. And so I have a Kukri set of tests coming out soon. And this one is going to be part of that hard fucking. I'm going to beat this like it fucked my wife. Okay. I am really going to just go medieval on this motherfucker. Okay. Booyah. All right. So we're going to see what the fuck I can do with this. And let's see, what else do I have here? Do I have anything else? I do have one more Shred Blade. No, Akasha is over there. Akasha was the motherfucker that cut that pig head in half. A frozen pig head. Took me like forever. It was my last real video I did like 2 or 3 fucking months ago. The one I did like the Walking Dead, you know, dealy on it. So this Shred. This is my Jason Voorhees, okay? Now, I'll do some discussion pieces about this and talk a little bit about it, because when I first saw the picture of it, I thought it was pretty interesting. Pretty interesting design, not too expensive, some very interesting usage as a machete. But then I got it, and the one thing that I noticed right off the back was this doesn't look sharp, right? It doesn't look sharp at all. You know, it looks like maybe a little bit sharp, maybe not that sharp. It's actually pretty grippy. It's pretty grippy, especially compared to like, you know, the notch system that you get on a Tops Blade, for example. When I first got a Tops Blade, I have a fond memory of trying to saw some shit, and that back on the Tops is not meant for sawing through shit. It's meant for notching. Okay. It's meant for you to make perfectly squared notches, which I didn't know that shit. I didn't know none of that shit. I had a brand new fucking Tops knife. I'm like, why won't this motherfucking saw? Right. So this one right here, super lightweight, very nimble in the hand, got a decent edge to it. And the saw back on here is pretty interesting. So I think I'd like to see what I could do with this, because like I said, the draw and appeal of a lot of the Shred Blades is the fact that they are budget conscious. It's not too expensive. They're not super cheap, but compared to the other blades that I like to buy, it's definitely lower on the price points. So, you know, I think out of all of the guys, the one voice I'd like to hear from would be Damien, because Damien always has the more colorful usage for some of the blade ideas and stuff like that. So Damien, I'm going to open the floor up to you. Feel free to come on down and, you know, share some of your inner thoughts, if you will. Yeah, come on down, get right by the microphone. Get right on the mic. There you go. Now, what do you think?
I would like to take the saw back, slide it between my enemy's thighs, and saw their balls in half.
Okay. All right. Apologies. I wasn't expecting that. I was going to say, like, saw an arm off or something. He's talking about cutting somebody from the fucking taint up. My lord. Anyway, cheap nut saw, you know, whatever. Not too bad. We will put this through its paces, too. I've always had a fondness for some of the lower end blades. Especially doing like some of the really hardcore chop tests. A lot of times they really surprise the shit out of me, especially if they're made with like 1070 or some of the softer metals. They tend to handle a lot of my tests a lot better than some of the more harder metals, like 1095, for example. Those tend to chip a little bit more. 1070 tends to handle a lot of my particular types of testing very well. Let's see. Here's a question I've been debating with my friend. Who would win, a grizzly bear or a silverback gorilla? Whoo! Let me think for a second. Let me think for a second. I'm going to go with the grizzly bear. And the reason I'm going to go with the grizzly bear is the claws and the bear hug. I think a gorilla is powerful as shit, but I think a good swipe to the jugular or the face of the gorilla would fucking ruin his day. I seem to be getting out fucking voted here. By most motherfuckers, I seem to be getting outvoted here. So Jeremiah says Silverback. Ready to Gear says Gorilla for the smarts. Jeremy Lawler says Silverback. It's kind of like the Batman versus Superman type question. We know if Batman has time to analyze the situation, he could use his intelligence. I'm picturing the Silverback sitting there. You know, he's taking a shit, right? He's sitting by a big tree. He's popping a squat, but he, unbeknownst to him, he took a shit on the wrong tree. It's the grizzly's fucking tree. The grizzly's not too happy about this. The grizzly's like, hey, motherfucker, that's my tree you just took a shit on. And the grizzly fucking comes running, bloop, 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 and this whack hits him, swipes the shit out of him, okay? And remember, the bear has these fucking claws, okay? So that's my guess. I'm thinking if the gorilla has time to fucking maneuver and outthink some shit, possibly. But raw fucking power in the moment, getting bum rushed, you got a fucking, you know, over 2,000-pound fucking bear pouncing on your ass. I don't know. My initial instincts is the grizzly. I don't know. Well, fuck, I'll ask the guys. You know, hey, Steve, what do you think?
Who the fuck cares?
Oh, you're always fucking useless. Okay, Randy, maybe you can shine a light.
What the fuck do I know about bears and grizzlies? Bears and fucking monkeys. I don't know. Fuck. I ride motorcycles.
Okay. All right.
Fuck. These guys are fucking useless. They're not helping me at all. I think it depends who gets the upper hand first. If the bear gets it and gets going, it has fangs and it has claws. But if the gorilla can get behind the grizzly, I think he has a chance.
All right. That's insightful. I like that. So anyway, I think, what is this here? That was a torture method in the medieval times. Victims are tied upside down and some victims survive for a long time. Huh. No way, Silverback. Yeah. You know what? I really don't know, guys. I chop frozen pig heads, but I still think the grizzly has, I think the grizzly has more tools to his advantage. I think the gorilla is very powerful, very strong, has its hands, can use items, things of that nature. But it seems like a lot of the confrontations that I've seen gorillas have against each other, they didn't seem super intelligent. They seem pretty brute, pretty powerful. So that's why I'm basing it, you know, power to power. That's a good question, though. That's a good question. I wonder if there's something on the internet where they did something scientifically where they put them up against each other. You know, one of these, like, it's like, who would win, an alligator or a fucking hippopotamus? You know, you would think, well, fucking alligator, right? Until you realize hippos kill a lot of motherfucking things. The jaw strength on them bastards is ridiculous. All right, so let's see, we're at 49 minutes. Out fucking standing. I'm on track. I'm doing good. I'm proud of myself. Usually I go off on fucking tangents and kind of go, but I'm doing pretty good. Time for another shot, though. It's time for another shot. Now, while I'm taking this shot, I'm going to talk about the war against the Illuminati. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying. I'm going to talk about the Illuminati. You know, the shadow government that is controlling the world around us, you know, the all-seeing fucking eye, you know, the MK Ultra programs, the Project Blue Beams with the alien holographic shit, you know, stuff like that. You know, I would smack the shit out the Illuminati. I would tell the Illuminati to kiss my motherfucking ass, and they could take it and stick it straight up their candy motherfucking ass. Oh, that's good. You know what I'm saying? Green Man, was my favorite large knife. It's M4X Punisher is my favorite large knife. And it is probably the most tested knife that I have. Although it lost in a side-by-side comparison to the SXB. The SXB beat the shit out of my M4X Punisher, and I was very sad and disheartened about it. Michael, what is your favorite gun? Right now, my favorite gun is kind of a toss-up between my Glock 27 and my Walther PPX. I like the trigger more on my Walther, but the reliability of my Glock, I mean, I have probably took 800 rounds through the Glock, and I only had one misfire, and that was because of the ammo. Ammo was shit, cheap fucking range ammo. And I like the form factor of the 27. It's smaller, carries that heavy load in it, and I'm really, really fucking accurate, left and right-handed. But I do like this. I do like this. So if the Illuminati ever shows up, I got something for the ass. I got something for them. I'll tell the Illuminati they can suck my motherfucking... What the fuck is that? What the fuck is Catcher in the Rye? Catcher in the Rye. Catcher in the Rye. Catcher in the Rye. The Illuminati are our friend. We should do what they tell us to do. The New World Order is a good thing. Just fucking around. I'm just fucking with you guys. Just fucking playing. Fucking Desert Eagle. Dude, have you ever fucking shot a fucking Desert Eagle? Matt, you had a Rhino? Dude, I like that Rhino. I actually want to get one of those to try it out. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking totally fucking... The Judge, that's another fucking gun I want to get. You know what I'm saying? That's another one I want to fucking get for reals. But I think it's time for another shot. I just did that Illuminati bit, and I got a nasty taste in my mouth. I got to get it out now. Felt like I just sucked the fucking New World Order's dick. You know what I mean? It was supposed to be a fucking funny joke, but now I'm kind of regretting doing it. You know? Anyway, I blame it on the fucking cough syrup I'm drinking here. The syrup. This is a syrup. Cheers, motherfuckers. That shit is really fucking good, guys. Super smooth, super easy to drink. And that's the bad part about it. That shit will get you fucked up in nothing flat. But I did not fucking do this on an empty stomach. I made sure that I got... hold the brakes. I have two rhinos been waiting for you to come to Georgia. Georgia? Shit, I'm on my way right now, motherfucker, for two rhinos. Those rhinos are fucking nice, dude. I fucking love them. They look fucking amazing. Let's see. Do you have a truck gun? Not necessarily a truck gun. All right, Ready to Gear. You have a fucking good night.
I don't have a fucking truck gun per se. What I do have.
I have this. This is my baby. Excuse me. Boop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop- fucking good. That'd have been good for a fucking, you know, little CG action right there, right? That would be. That's my fucking KSG. That's fucking Bertha. That's my big bitch right there. She's loaded with fucking 24 mini slugs. Yes, I said 24 mini slugs. Mini 1 ounce slugs. That's what she rolls with. She's a bad bitch. I love her. 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 The only thing I'd fucking swap her out for would be a fucking AA-12. AA-12? Yeah, I think it's called an AA-12. That's the semi, full auto, actually. Full auto fucking shotgun. That also can be deployed out with the little rocket shells. Oh, my fucking God. Ugh, rocket shells. Rocket shells. Fuck. My fucking Lord. God, I want one of those. But I'm not law enforcement or military, so I can't fucking have that. Can't have that. Can't have that. That's fucking wrong, right? Why can't I have one? Why can't I have a full automatic shotgun? I want one.
The fuck?
Anyway, I digress. All right, where are we at with time? 55 minutes? Yes, I covered everything. I've done countless fucking shots. I say countless because I don't remember how many shots I did. I'll do one more at the very end there just to toast out and cheer you motherfuckers. Johnny, motherfucker, I ain't seen you in a minute. It's good to see you, man. It's good to see you. It is really good to see you. You shoot one of those things one-handed. Yeah, the AA-12s, you most definitely can because those fuckers are balanced really nice. In fact, they have those things mounted on some of the drones, and it's amazing. It's fucking amazing. It really, really is. So anyway, what the fuck? Are you serious? Ready? Stop. You're bringing a tear to my eyes. You realize that's more than I made the first year on YouTube. I appreciate the fuck out of that, brother. I will. Thank you very much, Reddy. You're a gentleman and a scholar. Salute you, my good man. Fuck, I've never had one of those before. That shit is actually fucking crazy. It makes you feel all like, what? Oh my God. Oh, I feel so fucking funny inside. Thank you very much. So, as we wind down here, I got 4 fucking minutes left on this fucking episode. I hope you guys like this format. I tried to put something that has a little bit of fucking everything, you know, a little bit of alcohol, a little bit of pop culture, a little bit of fucking news, a little bit of Blades, a little bit of that. And then, of course, you know, I'm going to have the regular stuff where we have the shit outside where we're chopping on shit and breaking stuff and doing all kinds of craziness and stuff like that. But, let's see here. If you have a picture on account and have your subscribers send you cash, you can actually make lots of money. You have a picture on account. Well, you know what? I'm not really trying to make money. I'm just fucking hanging out and having fucking fun. Peace, brother. Patreon. I have a Patreon account. I just have never set it up all the way. I just fucked with it. You know what I mean? I have it, but I had it as a backup in case YouTube fucking died. That was the thought there. I was like, if YouTube fucking takes a shit, then I'll have something. You know what I mean? I'm new YouTuber of Bushcrap Survival. Do you have any suggestions? Stick with it. Have fucking fun. Don't get obsessed with trying to get fucking subs and all that other stuff. Just put the content out. Have fucking fun. The community is fucking amazing. They will flock to you. They'll support you. And like me, it's like, I'll go check your shit out. I'll give you pointers and stuff like that. I'll try to, point you in the right direction with all of this design stuff. Like, I'm really good at shit like that. So, I've helped a couple of different channels with some of their design stuff. Like, I've done stuff with, Drop 4 Survival, his wife, which is, Outdoor Mama or something like that. I've also done some others. Anyway, people basically are really, really, really fucking cool. This is one of the nicest verticals, nicest communities. The knife and gun community is super, super fucking cool. Bushcraft especially. Very small knit group of fuckers. And don't take shit too seriously. You'll get trolls that come in every so often. Just ignore them. Don't feed them. Just ignore them. Have fucking fun. If it's your passion and it's stuff that you love, it'll come out. People will just fucking enjoy it because everybody who does shit that they love, that they have passion with, people fucking, it's contagious. You know, you smile, you love it. They smile, they love it. So, I can give you more concrete, advice and stuff as we go, but you know, right now I'm just drinking, so I might not be completely coherent. All right, so we got 59 minutes. Awesome. Let's do one more fucking shot. We'll do one more shot to you good motherfuckers. I love you guys. You guys fucking... Oh, that was a big shot. It's going to be a big shot. Big shot, motherfuckers. A bigger, bigger shot. Yes, indeed. I love the fucking beaver. I love the beaver. All right, here we go. God damn, that's good. It's good, guys. Seriously. If you like the minty shit, boom, winner chicken fucking dinner. All right guys, I don't currently have internet, so I use buddies when I visit. Maybe I can get internet again when we get moved to Colorado. Yeah, I hope so, brother. See, look, we already got Nomadic. He said he'll fucking subscribe to you, brother. And you know what? If you want to put your link, put that shit in here. You know, I think on the chat, I think actually, guys, if you're on the chat and you see him, I think all you have to do is go to the right. There is three little dots that are there. And then what it does is it says go to channel. So I'm going to go to the channel right now because this is my thing and it might not let you guys put a link in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go here and I'm going to put his fucking link in. Let's see if it'll let me do it. There we go. So right there in the chat, that's fucking Green Man's Bushcraft and Survival. He just started. He just started. So don't be fucking critical on his shit. Go see what he's got going on. Check his shit out. You know, show some motherfucking love and all that jazz. And, I meant to tell you something else. Fuck, did Shannon get in here? I don't know if he's in here. One of the viewers, he's actually making Angry Jackalope stickers. And I told him, because he was like, dude, I'll give you some of the stuff. And I'm like, no, fuck that, dude. If you're making a fucking sticker, it's like I gave him the artwork of the logo and stuff. I said, here's the artwork. Go ahead and do what you fucking want. And him and his wife are making stickers and shit. I think it's like a dollar an inch. So if you wanted a 12-inch fucking, right there, Magic Ghost. So talk to Magic Ghost if you want fucking, by the way, the Grizzly would win. if you want a 12-inch sticker, it'd be like 12 fucking bucks. So I told him, you keep the fucking money. You guys go ahead and support him. Contact Magic and say, hey, I'm interested in getting some Angry Jackalope's fucking stickers and shit. He'll hook you up. You know what I mean? He's a fucking good dude. Longtime fucking friend of the channel and shit. And anybody else, any of you guys got stuff that you need me and my measly 2,000 plus subscribers to shine some fucking light on, I'm more than happy to do it. I love good causes. I love good people. I like helping the community and shit like that. So, you know, if there's anything that comes up, you guys need advice or anything else, holla at your boy. All right, guys, that's it. That's going to end this fucking episode. I fucking love you guys. I appreciate the fuck you guys taking time out of your busy fucking schedules to come and check my shit out. You know, I appreciate it to no fucking end. So, you know, if you guys like this shit, just, you know, just keep watching. I don't want you to fucking keep subbing, sharing, any of that shit. You don't need none of that. You just come hang out, fucking have a good fucking time, and that's it. This is my passion. I enjoy doing this shit. I enjoy sharing with you motherfuckers. So that's it. You guys have a glorious fucking Saturday. I'm fucking done. All right, guys. Episode 1 is officially finished.